गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। सो स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ। टुडे आई मिस गरिमा सिंह, योर एबेकस टीचर, विल टीच यू दिस सब्जेक्ट। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग वी विल डिस्कस दैट व्हाट इज एबेकस। एबेकस इज अ मैनुअल एड टू कैलकुलेट। इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ बीट्स और डिस्क दैट कैन बी मूव्ड अप और डाउन ऑन अ सीरीज ऑफ स्टिक्स और स्ट्रिंग्स विद इन अ यूजुअली वुडन फ्रेम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। First of all, we will discuss some parts of the abacus. As I know that you have previously studied this, but we will discuss it again. The outer part is called the frame. The lower one are called the lower beads, and the beads which are up, they are called the upper beads. The mid part is called the beam, and the rods which are going from vertically up to down are called the rods of abacus. So, now we have studied about the parts of abacus. Now see students, here in front of you one abacus stool is there. The mid rod is called the home column. It is the rod from where all the calculations are being done. Now let's take the value of the beads. The home column, which you have seen this time, is the main rod. Its value is 1. The lower bead value is 1. And the upper bead value is 5. As you can see very clearly. Now the second rod, which is called the tens rod, which is just besides the unit rod. The upper bead has the value 50. And the lower bead has the value 10. Now the next we will take hundreds rod, which is just besides the tens rod. The upper bead value is 500. And the lower bead value is 100. As we can see, it is the 11th column. Now, let's start. For doing plus operation, we have to put the beads up. As you can see very clearly, for minus operation, you have to put the beads down. One thing again, as the bead touches the bar, it attains a value. As you can see, for plus operation, the upper bead has to go down, and for minus operation, the upper bead has to go up. As the bead touches the bar, it attains a value, as you can see in the plus part. Now for 50, if you have to add 50, then you have to put the bead down. And if you have to minus 50, then you have to put the bead up. This is what tens rod. Now see how clearly you can do plus 20, plus 30, plus 40, plus 10. For plus 10, 1 bead up. For plus 20, 2 beads up. Plus 30, 3 beads up. Plus 40, 4 beads up. Now we will go for minus 10, minus 20, minus 30, minus 40. For minus 10, you have to do 1 bead down. For minus 20, you have to do 2 beads down. Minus 30, 3 beads down. Minus 40, 4 beads down. Now see, before starting, we will see that how you should sit for doing abacus. First of all, put the abacus on the table. Sit straight on your chair and don't lean on the table. Then hold the abacus from your left hand side and do with the right hand side. Learn tables from 2 to 20. For this, it's very important to learn the tables from 2 to 20. Now multiplication with 2 and 3 using abacus tool. As students, I'm again saying, for this calculation, you should learn the table from 2 to 9. Very thoroughly. Now we will discuss about the zero rule. In this calculation, you should know the zero rule. What is the zero rule? This rule states that whenever we get a single digit number in the beginning or first stage, we have to put a zero in beginning. You will get more about this rule by applying it in the method. Now let's start and see a video.
Students, now see, in front of me one abacus tool is there. Now before starting, you have to set your abacus. Put all the upper beads up and the lower beads down, like this. Now we will start. As I've told you earlier, that this is the units rod. Besides the units rod, there is the tens rod, and besides the tens rod, there is the hundreds rod. You have to start the calculation from the hundreds rod. Today, we will take the mathematical calculation from 2 and 3, means the product of 2 and 3 we will take today. Now, as I told you earlier, this is the home position. Now, we will take our first question. 23 into 2. Now, first of all, multiply the first digit with the first number. 2 into 2, which is 4. As you can see, that 4 is a single digit number, so you will apply the zero rule here. As I have told you earlier, what is the zero rule? In zero rule, you have to write the number and you have to apply one zero in front of it. Now, the work of abacus. As I have told you, that you have to start the calculation from the hundreds rod. So, in hundreds rod, the first number is 0, so nothing we will do. Second is 4, so we will do 1, 2, 3, 4. See, 4. Now, we will multiply 3 with 2. 3, 2 is a 6. 5, 6 in units rod. Now, what is the answer? 46. The answer is 46. See how easily you can take out the answer from this abacus tool. Secondly, we will take 38 into 2. First of all, multiply the first digit with 2. 3 into 2. 3 into 2 is 6. Again, it is a single digit number. So, we will apply the zero rule here. In zero rule, we will apply the zero in front of 6. Now, before doing the abacus tool, set your abacus tool again, like this. Now, zero in the first position means hundreds rod. We have to start our calculation from the hundreds rod. Zero means nothing. Next is 6. We apply 5, 6. Now, the next digit, 8 into 2. It is 16. So, it is 1 and 6. So, 1 we will do in tens rod and 6 in the units rod. What is the answer? 50, 60, 70. The answer is 76. Now, the same we will take for 3. The next is a number product with 3. First of all, we will take the first number. Multiply the first number with 3. 4 into 3. 4 3 is a 12. As you can see, the number is a 2 digit number. It is not a single digit number. So, we will not apply the zero rule here. 12. Simply 12. Set your abacus again. Now, 12 means 1 and 2. The first number in the hundreds rod. 1 and then 2. 1, 2. Now, the next digit. 3 into 3. 3 3 is a 9. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in the tens rod, units rod, sorry. So, 100, 20 and 9. The answer is 129. Now, the fourth question. 62 into 3 is equals to how much? First of all, multiply the first digit with the first number. 6 into 3. 6, 6, 3 is a 18. It is a double digit number. Set your abacus. Now 18, 1, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now the next digit. 2 into 3. 3 2s are 6. 6 in the next units rod. 5, 6. See, 100, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 5, 6. 186.
Now let's revise. As today we have studied first of all about the parts of abacus, frame, lower beads, upper beads, rod, beam. Then we have studied about the units rod. The mid rod is called the units rod, then tens rod, then hundreds rod, and then higher places like thousands, lakh. Then we have studied about the zero rule. A zero rule states that when the single digit is there in the beginning, then only we will apply it. Then specially focus on learning the tables. First of all, you should learn the tables from 2 to 20, but it should be thoroughly till 2 to 9. And our topic multiplication with 2 and 3 using Abacus tool. The more you practice, the better the results. I am giving you one worksheet with this video. Please do it in your rough notebook. Thank you.